So a week ago, Apple had an event at 420 called the Spring Loaded event, the first Apple event this year, and it was virtual due to COVID restrictions. As usual, new devices were announced and some released. These include the purple iPhone 12 and 12 mini, the new Apple iPad Pro that actually has the M1 chip, the new iMac, Apple TV 4K, and finally the long-awaited AirTags, which I'm about to talk about in this video. What is up, guys? How you doing? Hope your day is going well. I'm Milan and welcome to Fuzzy Tech. If you're new here and like this video, don't leave without clicking that subscribe button. And if you're a returning subscriber, thanks a lot for subscribing to me. I really appreciate it. This is the fifth episode in Tech Talks, and if you haven't watched the previous four, check out the playlist in my channel and you won't regret it. I promise you that. So an AirTag is a small tracking device that looks like a button and was designed by Apple. It keeps track of small useful stuff such as keys and wallets and can help find them if they are lost. You just attach it to the stuff, then that's it. It uses Apple's Find My app, which usually helps find your other devices connected in iCloud. The design of an AirTag is pretty basic with no weird features or extraordinary features. It's just made of, okay, part of it is made of stainless steel, the middle part. Then it also has a built-in speaker that can help you find your item if it's close by, and a removable cover that makes it easier for you to replace the battery. And the feature that stood out for me is its water resistance ability, IP67 to be precise. Now, if you have any knowledge on how AirPods, or rather any other type of earpods nowadays connects, it's just by bringing them close to your phone and then they show up on your device. Now, that's how AirTags connect too. When you bring it close to your iPhone, it shows up and it can connect. You can give it a custom name, for example, keys if it's for your keys, bag if it's for your bag, and basically, you can name your AirTag whatever name you want, just to identify it. After it's set up, you can use the Find My app to locate it if it's nearby, particularly within Bluetooth range. So just within the house, it's good, unless you live in a mansion or something. You could even ask Siri to find it for you, and it will play a sound for you to find it. For iPhone 11 and 12 users only, I think, it has precision finding, where it basically shows you directions to follow, like go right, go left, and so on. And it seems fun. Now, let's say you left your AirTag in your backpack and forgot it just somewhere out there, a place that is far away from the Bluetooth range. It uses the Find My network to help you find its location. How it works is you just mark it as lost in the Find My app. You can leave your phone number and a message with that. Then any iPhone user that has the UI and is around the AirTag can find it as lost and notify you, the owner. If you've left your information there, it's better. Now, this is good, but sadly, the iPhone is not that common outside the US. So it's a little bit inconvenient in other countries around the world, but it's not fully inconvenient. If you have an Android and find that tag, you can scan it with NFC and it will bring you to a website with the information of that owner. And so you can notify them, you can call them or send them a text message. Now, with a device like this, there must obviously be security concerns. Like, what if someone uses the AirTag to follow you and track you? So the Find My app will notify you if an unknown AirTag is following you and is not with the owner. It will not notify you once away, but it will wait until you reach to a significant point, like your home or just a stopping point, sort of a destination. Then it tells you. This will prevent, you know, many notifications, because you may pass by the AirTag, but it's not someone following you. It's just a lost one or one left nearby. So it's not 100% safe, but it's okay. No, in fact, it's good. Yeah, it's really good. On to the price. For one AirTag, you get one at $25 and $99 for a pack of four. If I were to use an AirTag, I'd probably put it with my keys, since I literally lose my keys on daily, my backpack just in case, and I don't think anything else. So for me, I think that price is a little bit high. since I don't think I'll spend like $50 for that function. I think they should have been for a cheaper price, but hey, that's Apple for you. So if you have an iPhone and live in a place where iPhones are common, like the US, I think it's a good device and you should buy it if you can afford it, of course. Anyways, that's all for today, guys. I'm Milan and this is FuzzyTech. Thanks for watching. And if you're a new viewer, click that subscribe button to check out my other videos. Bye and hope you have a lovely day. Peace.